Good day, everyone. So, this is the examples now that we will be answering following the updates of the handouts number 2. So, here in problem number 1, you just follow on your handouts no, sa mga steps nga kinahanglan. So, example number 1, no? So design a rectangular beam reinforced for tension only to carry a dead load moment of 56 kN meter. This is in moment na, no? Including its own weight, and a live load moment of 47 kN meter. So use F prime of C equal to 20.7 MPa, and Fy, the specific yield strength of the steel, 276 MPa. So let us do this step by step following your handouts, no? So the step number 1 is to determine the values of loads, the dead load, live load, and other loads. So in this problem, it is specifying only the dead load and live load, no? We have the dead load 56 kN meter including its own weight, and the live load 47 kN meter. And the next step is approximate the weight of beam. We have the dead load, no, as follows. So kung small beams, medium sized beam, large beams, or weight of beam 24 kN cubic meter times the cross-sectional area. But in this case, no, the dead load already includes the weight of the beam, so there's no need to look for a value sa step number 2, no. Okay, the dead load given already includes the weight of the beam. So sa step number 3 is to compute the factored load on different load combinations. So example, the 1.2 dead load live load, dead load, and 1.6 live load, no. So computing mu, we have 142.4 kN meter. And step number 4, the step number 3 is considering na ay kita hay kanam other loads other than dead load and live load. No, we have the earthquake load, wind loads. If ever kanang naapon na siya available nga given, then mo to pang ano pang pilian nato to proceed to number 4, we have to compute the factor moment carried by the beam. Okay, so we just adapt the value, no? So mu is equals to 142.4 kN meter. So that is for step number 4. The next step, step number 5, we have, we try the value of steel ratio rho from 0.7 of rho max to 0.8 of rho max, but must not be less than the value of the rho minimum. Now let us try na ito using 0.7 of the rho max. Now with the new value na sa rho max, new formula, rho max is equals to itong derive na to, no? Nga derive na ito nino sa 3/7 of 0.85 F prime of C beta 1 over Fy. So using this formula, times sa na ito with F prime of C 20.7 na given, Fy 276 megapascal, then beta 1 is 0.85 for F prime of C less or equal than 28 MPa. So we adapt the value of beta 1, 0.85. So substituting all values, no? So we have rho max is equals to 3/7 times 0.85, 20.7 MPa times 0.85 all over 276 MPa. We get rho max is equals to 0.02322321429. Then times 0.7 para mga value na itong rho, kaya ito mag-assume na rho, the value of rho will be 0.7 times the rho max. So we get the value of rho ang itong gamiton is equal to 0.01625625. Then, na naman tayo value sa rho, then we need to check for the above pa siya sa rho minimum. If ever ma-check na to, it is below the value of the minimum, then we adapt the raw minimum. So with, di ba, check pa na ito nga, if ang atong F primus is greater than 31.36 MPa, then we use this value of raw min, kani 0.25 square root of F primus over Fy. Otherwise, raw min is equals to 1.4 over Fy. So our F prime of C is 20.7 man, it is less than 31.36, therefore we adapt the value of rho mean equal to 1.4 over Fy. So rho mean is equals to 1.4 over 276 MPa, we get 0.005072. Comparing it with the rho, 0.7 of rho max, therefore we conclude that the rho that we are using is greater than rho mean, therefore it is satisfactory, no, within the code requirement. So therefore we use the value of rho 0.01625625. Okay, then the step number 6 is to compute for the omega equal to rho Fy over F prime of C. So substituting the values, no, ang rho ang atong nakuha is 0.01625625 times Fy 276 MPa all over 20.7 MPa. We get the value of the omega 0.21675. So with that, okay, so going to step number 7. So, step number 7, no, we need to solve for the reduction factor phi. So, for the reduction factor phi, we will use a strength reduction factor phi. Why do we need to solve, you know, kay sa previous na itong handouts of videos? That is following sa kuan pa, 2001, nga, ubag design ta, diretso, nag-diretso sa 0.9 ang phi na to kung mag-design ta kay siya matanga o mag-design ta ang yield yun na siya kapunay pero kung manto mo sa inyo handouts na i-graph ito ka na ang phi versus the kanang the strain if you notice nga after from balance condition to tension control, so that transition region is mo yield pa na siya kay kuan ang Fy na to ana is great, ang Fs na to ana ang stress nga na experience sa steel is greater than the value of the Fy, so ni yield pa na siya pero transition region na siya, therefore kung sa transition nga region siya na belong is lahi ang phi niya. It is solve nun to siya 0.65 plus 0.25 times the quantity by the Fs minus Fy over 1000 minus Fy. Okay, so let us check if ang atong design is in transition region or tension control na siya. So Fs is equals to 600 times D minus C all over C. Now, so solve po na to ang C. So because C is directly proportional with rho, meaning there have a linear relationship, meaning all say factor na gi times na to sa rho max para natay rho nga value, therefore para makuha na to ang C nga value corresponding sa rho nga itong gamit is ato na pong times na ng C max sa factor nga itong gigamit, no? In this case is katong 0.7 kaya mo may atong gipili sa problem, no? So this one C max is equals to 3/7 of D times na nina to og factor ng 0.7 mo na na-value sa C. So, ratio factor may range from 0.7 to 0.8 as suggested in step number 5. Now, kani siya is, kung ano siya? Take note nga, These are just suggestion. These are not in the kuan in the NCP. Kuan lang siya kanang guide lang ni nga mas favorable sa pagdesign or mas kuan mas safe kayo. Close to row max ang atong gamiton is kuan man. Basta yung ginigran up na to is malapas na siya sa maximum allowed of reinforcement then ma compression control na hinon siya. Okay, so if any solve na to Fs is greater equal to 1000 MPa, that is tension control, meaning ang strain sa steel nga na-experience na niya is 0.005. Then if Fs is less than 1000 MPa, but greater than Fy, therefore it is in transition region where we need to solve for Phi equal to 0.65 plus 0.25 Fs minus Fy all over 1000 minus Fy. So Fs is equals to 600 times D minus C over C, where C is equals to 0.7 times C max. So C is equals to 0.7 times 37 times D, we get C is equals to 0.3 D. Then substitute that to sa Fs, kanibal niyo sa C, so Fs is equals to 600 times D minus 0.3 D over 0.3 D. Then, pwede ma-extract na to ang D over D. So, ma-cancel na siya. May 1. Therefore, si Fs equals to 600 times 1 minus 0.3 all over 0.3. Fs equals to 1,400 MPa, which is greater than 1,000 MPa. Therefore, tension control na siya sa pag-design na to. We use Phi is equals to 0.9. So, step number 8 is to solve for BD squared. So, going back to the formula, no? Na-derive man nila to sa mga previous videos na to, mu is equals to phi f prime c omega BD squared times 1 minus 0.59 omega. Where, ma-extract na tong BD squared, may mong equal to mu over phi f prime c omega times 1 minus 0.59 omega. So, where omega is equals to 0.21675. Then phi nga itong gamitin is 0.9. F prime of C is equals to 20.7 MPa. Mu is 142.4 km meter. And we substitute now kana nganong naman ni 1000 squared to ano para makonsistent ta sa atong units kay kN man siya atong himo Newton then kaning meter himo na to mm para ang mabili squared na tong answer is in cubic millimeter or millimeter cube. So BD squared is equals to 40,435,519.5 sorry, cube ni siya, cube millimeter cube. Okay. Okay, so cube na sub na na. So this is now the value of the BD squared. Okay, so next step is to try a ratio of D over B. Same gapo no? 1.5 B to 2 will be ang D. So solve for D, round off the value of to a reasonable dimension. So same ra gapo no? To the nearest 25 mm. Check also the minimum thickness of the beam required by the code. But if we look in the code para sa to check the minimum thickness is we need the span of the beam. Now, unfortunately, there is a problem. The span is given, so we cannot check for now. No? So if the span is given, then you need to solve to check the minimum thickness. No? It is in your handouts, no? Katong provision ano. Then after solving for D, substitute its value to step number 7 and solve for B. And compute the weight of the beam and compare it to assumption. So, wala man ta nag-assume. So, you need not follow this. Okay. Okay, Okay, so next we try d is equals to 2 times then bd squared is equals to 40,435,519.5 cubic millimeter cubic. So substitute na to on 2b. So 4b cube. Then we get b is equals to 16.22 mm. Say b is equals to 225 millimeter. Then d is equals to 2b. 2 times 216.22, 432.44. Then say d is equals to 450 mm. So solve for the required steel area and the number of bars n. So A is equals to rho BD, where number of bars, to get the number of bars, we need to know the diameter D na itong gamiton sa bar. So pi over 4D squared times number of bars n is equals to AS. So say B is equals to 225 mm, D to 450 mm, rho, itong nasolve niya is 0.016 to 56.25. Then substitute na to, we get AS is equals to 1,645.945 millimeter square. Then to get the we try using 20 mm diameter rebar, we get pi over 4 20 squared times n, we get n is equals to 5.24. say n is equals to 20 mm diameter rebar. So as for the pagdraw sa section sa arrangement, I know kay bao na mo ito, no? So I just run through with the ano bag with the updates sa atong handouts. So this procedure will be used na ninyo sa kuan atong midterm exam. That is my siguro na kung update ni siya part. Okay, so this is example number 2.